Do you want to go from this to this, or from this to this? Please keep watching and I'm gonna show you how. Hello guys, welcome to my first video tutorial. I'm gonna show you how to set up the official Toon Shader used by Unity Technology's Japanese branch. First of all, I'd like to give all credits to the developers of this tool. They worked very hard to code this tool and also went through the trouble of making it available for free with detailed tutorials. Thanks a lot for that. You can access the original GitHub repository from this link that I'll put on the description. Just two quick notes before we begin. This won't instantly convert your whole projects into the Toon look with just a few clicks, because it requires a specific workflow that starts very early on the 3D modeling phase, texture creation, URP graphic settings, and such. But you can still get cool results even without all that required preparation. And finally, this tool can also work with HDRP and the built-in legacy render pipeline, but the video would get very long if I taught how to set up the three versions. If you need help with other pipelines besides URP, just send me a message, alright? So, if you're aiming for the Toon look, then even the best 3D models won't be enough. You need specific shaders to make your games look more cartoonish, otherwise they would have this classic kinda realistic 3D look that comes with Unity's standard shaders. If you don't know what shaders are, in a very basic description, shaders are programs that run on your graphics processing units, the GPU. They tell how Unity should display game objects on your screen, what color each pixel should have, and they can change other properties too. And the free shader we are gonna use is called UnityChan Toon Shader 3. Have you ever heard about UnityChan? She is the mascot that represents Unity in Japan, and they made a lot of material related to her free to use, like 3D models, voice packs, art, and toon shaders, which is what we are looking for. Just make sure to read the license on their website before you start using their resources. Okay, so let's begin for real. First, access this GitHub repository from the link I put on the description. I have simplified the original folder structure, so you can just drag and drop these files into your Unity project. Find this green code button, then click on the download zip option. The file has about 40 megabytes. Extract the zip file you just downloaded. Open the UTS-3 Toon Shader folder, and you're ready to drag and drop these three folders into your Unity project. But if you already have an editor folder in your Unity project, don't drag this folder here. Instead, just grab these files and drag them into your already existing editor folder. Now, I'm going to create a new URP project and delete all the default assets just so we don't get confused. We are gonna drag those three folders into our assets folders, and we are almost done. Let's set up the demo scenes according to the original documentation. We need to select the recommended graphic settings that came with the original shader. You can find the recommended settings in the demo scenes folder, RP assets, and there they are. To activate them, go to the project settings menu, and in the graphics tab, select these UTS-2 URP pipeline assets. Finally, in the player tab, open the other settings and make sure that the color space is set to linear. And that's it! You're finally ready to explore all the demo scenes on this folder here. And that's it guys, this setup is done, and now you're ready to study the official documentation and learn how to use the shader in more detail. You're gonna find a very detailed written tutorial on the original GitHub repository. The link will be on the description. Now, I'm gonna show you how I converted the default URP scene into the Toon look. I have created a new URP project, and I'm going to drag these three folders into my project. I'm gonna select the recommended graphic settings and make sure that the color space is linear. Get all the materials of this scene and change the shader to Universal Render Pipeline Toon. Now, I have to manually drag every single base texture map into the first shade texture map slot. This is one of the many reasons why you don't change your shaders in the middle of a project, by the way. And we need to darken the first shade color for our very material so their shadows can appear. I'm gonna increase the outline width to 20 and choose the black color so we can clearly see it. Improve the directional light, change the scene a little bit. Steal the rotating camera from the demo scenes, and voila! The default URP scene is already looking a lot more cartoonish. We still need to tweak the settings to get better results, though. But this is just a quick demonstration. That's all for my first tutorial, buddies. Thanks a lot for watching. Now you can learn more about the shader on the official documentation. Before I go, I'd like to give a special shout out to my colleagues from GameDevTV's Discord. I get so much help from the server. The community here is very friendly and professionally managed by the student-focused GameDevTV team. If you want to join us, access the invitation link that is available on the description. On this server, you are gonna find many knowledgeable people who are willing to help. For example, UnderdogDev posts very funny production process videos on his YT channel. Check him out sometime. Or Zasix, who's very experienced and runs this interesting website with well-written blog posts. And there's also Anthony, who can code cool games and give you awesome tips. This was just to name a few of the helpful people you're gonna find there, and I hope to see you there too. See you later. Bye-bye.